I had appealed to numerous social organizations to come forward to beautify our stations. I am happy to inform that walls of many stations have been converted to murals, which has not only improved the aesthetics but also spread awareness on socially relevant themes. One such theme that deserves special mention is wildlife conservation, illustrated to the paintings done at Sawai Madhopur station. Hazaribagh, Borivali, Khar, Udaipur, Bikaner, of some of other stations, we showcase local art and talent. I thank them all and request similar support next year for aesthetic upgradation of our station. To provide better security to our passengers, especially women travelers, All India 24/7 helpline number 182 was started. CCTV surveillance provided at 311 stations, and all major stations will be brought under CCTV surveillance in a phased manner. A single accident or loss of a single life causes me great sorrow and anguish. It also demonstrates that we'll have to go a long way to go in realizing our objective of a zero accident regime. Although our safety record is better at 20% lower accident this year as compared to the previous year, there is much more that is required to be done. I truly believe that a way forward is to eliminate accident is through adoption and assimilation of latest technology. We have entered into R&D partnership with leading railway institutions of the world, Railway Technical Research Institute of Japan, Korean Railway Research Institute. They will work with us to improve operations on existing network and hence provide a roadmap for zero accident railway system in India. In the interim, we have examined the recommendations of the committee headed by Dr. Kakodkar and are working on their implementation. We are also working on anti-fouling measures for overcrowded trains, mainly in the suburban sections. In 2015-16, we have closed 350 unmanned level crossings and eliminated 1,000 unmanned level crossings. 820 ROBs and RUBs have been completed in the current year, and work is going on 1,350 more. In my last budget speech, I had promised annualized saving of rupees 3,000 crores to be achieved by the third year on energy. I am happy to announce that a target will be achieved in the next financial year itself, a year earlier than envisaged. For the first time, we leverage provisions of the Electricity Act to procure power directly at competitive rates using our status as deemed distribution licenses. Power procurement contracts already signed and implemented will mean an annualized saving of rupees 1,300 crores. Further actions to source power already initiated will deliver annualized saving of 1,700 crores during the coming year, taking the total to rupees 3,000 crores. In addition, the saving of rupees 300 crores is being targeted through demand-side management and energy efficiency. Locomotives with auxiliary load are now being manufactured by us. Use of these locos will enable elimination of power cars, thereby replacing them with passenger coaches, which will enhance the carrying capacity of 10 and significantly reduce the travel time, noise level, fuel consumption and carbon footprint. 4 such locos have been turned in the current financial year, and another 39 are expected in the next year. Rail University is an important enabler to build sustained flow of skilled manpower, a prime requisite for any world-class railway system. We identified the National Academy of Indian Railways at Vadodara as a first institution which will be upgraded to a full-fledged university. Preparations are in full swing to establish the university during this year. As an organization, we cannot progress on the path of prosperity unless the path is digitally illuminated. This year, an application of track management system was launched. With this, activities of track inspection, monitoring and maintenance has thus been switched over to an IT platform, and automatic alerts in the form of SMS and emails are being generated. Inventory management module of TMS has resulted in inventory reduction of 27,000 metric ton, resulting in a saving of 64 crores, and scrap identification of 22,000 metric ton, equivalent to 53 crores. During this year, the system will be implemented throughout the railway network. We have developed an application for maintaining centralized land data and records of all land holding that we have now been digitized. As I move on to illustrate the new initiative, let me take a step back. One of the thrust areas of last year's budget was giving passengers better services and making railway journeys enjoyable. We'll continue to build on this momentum and strive hard to ensure satisfaction of each of the 7 billion passengers that ride railways network annually. Ours is a common man's government, working tirelessly for the benefit of all, especially farmers, workers, women, disabled and the impoverished. Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas is not just a slogan for us, it pervades all our thoughts and actions. Every customer is our brand ambassador, the very reasons of our existence. Therefore, each time that he or she travels, the satisfaction quotient must go up. In pursuance of making each of our customers happy, I propose to take the following measures. For the unreserved passengers, we'll start, this is a new product, not a train, this will be there all over, Antyodaya Express and Deen Dayalu coaches. This government truly believes that the fate of India would not change unless the lives of the common man or woman improve. Not only he or she is a center point of our policy making, but is ubiquitous to our public discourse and in our ideology. We propose to introduce Antyodaya Express, a long-distance, fully unreserved super-fast train service for the common man to be operated on dense routes. We will also add 2 or 4 Deen Dayalu coaches in some long-distance trains for unreserved travel to enhance our carrying capacity for the masses. These coaches will also have facility for potable drinking water and higher number of mobile charging points. For the reserved passengers, we are starting 3 new products. Hum Safar, Tejas and Uday. I am announcing 3 TRELEX services to ensure cost recovery by way of tariff and non-tariff measures. Hum Safar would be fully air-conditioned third AC service with an optional service for meals. Tejas, on the other hand, will showcase the future of train travel in India, operating at a speed of 130 km per hour and above. It will offer onboard services such as entertainment, local cuisine, Wi-Fi, etc. through one service provider for ensuring accountability and improved customer satisfaction. We'll also introduce overnight double-decker Uday Express on the busiest route, which has the potential to increase carrying capacity by almost 40%. To continue the efforts in minimizing waiting time for passengers at booking windows, we intend to commence sale of tickets through handheld terminal for the benefit of the suburban and short distance travelers. This should enable us to deploy multiple point of sales with minimum infrastructure. We also intend initiating sale of platform tickets through ticket vending machine, which will be made compatible with not only cash but also credit and debit cards. In the next 3 months, we'll open the e-ticketing facility for foreign debit and credit card holders, particularly for the foreign tourists and the NRIs. For our journalist friends, we will provide e-booking of tickets on the concessional passes available to them. This has been a long-pending request, and it is my privilege to provide them with this service, hoping that they will cover it better. Cancellation of PRS tickets requires a passenger to travel to a booking window to avail the refund within a prescribed time. This is a source of great discomfort. We will now open the facility of cancellation through the 139 helpline, post-verification using one-time password sent to registered phone members. We will introduce barcoded tickets, scanners and access control on a pilot basis on major stations to tackle the menace of ticketless travel and ensure hassle-free travel for the genuine passengers. We have taken a number of measures to improve service during the morning tatkal hours, yet there are complaints of rightful passengers being denied train tickets. We therefore intend to progressively ensure CCTV coverage at all tatkal counters. We plan to institutionalize a system of third-party periodic audits and certification of security features of the PRS website so it cannot be hacked. The Vikalp Alternative Train Accommodation System scheme, introduced in October 2015, will be expanded to provide choice of accommodation in specific trains to wait-listed passengers. This has been a great response from the people and we want to increase it. Taking forward the momentum on Swachh Rail, Swachh Bharat, we intend taking a string of measures to improve the cleanliness stations and trains. Introducing Clean My Coach service, which is already there, on pan-India basis, where a passenger can request cleaning of the coach or a toilet on a demand through SMS, so that instantly the service will be provided. Ranking of A1 and A-class stations based on a regular periodic third-party audit and feedback from passengers. Setting up of a waste segregation and recycling centers at A1 category station in a phased manner. 5 centers to be commissioned in the next financial year itself. undertaking awareness campaign, installing additional 30,000 bio toilets, providing portable structures with bio toilets at all platforms for select station for senior citizens, divyang and women. Catering has been one of the main issues and also source of satisfaction as well as complaint. Catering has been an important parameter for customer satisfaction. In pursuit of our objective to provide quality food to customers, the following measures are taken. IRCTC would begin to manage catering services in a phased manner. IRCTC will unbundle catering services by creating a distinction primarily between food preparation and food distribution. Extending e-catering service from the existing 45 large stations to all 408 A1 and A-class stations. Explore the possibility of making mandatory catering service optional in train. Local cuisine of choice will be made available to the passengers. Adding 10 more IRCTC operated mechanized sophisticated base kitchen to ensure fresh and hygienic supply of food on train. Mandating third-party audit in order to ensure desired level of quality in catering services. Introducing a new policy of multi-purpose as against existing single-purpose stalls at stations where each stall can provide multiple services required by passengers, including milk products and OTC medicines. Enforcing reservation in catering unit to scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, other backward classes, women, divyang, etc. We will also introduce a sub-quota of 33% for women in each of the reserved category. Further, to build local ownership and employment, a process of giving weightage to district domicile holders for commercial licenses at stations would be initiated, as you have seen in the past, that one contractor could tap all the stalls. We are going to be also using all the technical halls as commercial halls on the long distance train. We have introduced Sarthi Seva in Konkan Railway to help the old and disabled passengers requiring assistance at stations. We'll expand this service at many more stations. We'll strengthen the existing service for enabling passengers to book battery-operated cars, porter services on a paid basis in addition to the existing pickup and drop and wheelchair services. For the divyang, and with the objective of Accessible India campaign, we'll ensure that all stations under redevelopment are accessible to divyang. We will make efforts to provide at least one divyang-friendly toilet in each platform in A1 class station during this financial year and the next financial year, and also ensure availability of wheelchairs in sufficient numbers at these stations. There is a continuous effort on our part to ensure safe and secure travel for our passengers. Yet, untoward incidents occur. To minimize the financial loss to passengers from such events, we are working with insurance companies to offer optional travel insurance for rail journeys at the time of booking itself. Passengers transiting in our network now could book on an hourly basis the retiring rooms that are available. Madam, we are starting a Janani Seva. We would like to mitigate the hardship that mothers undergo while travelling with their infants, and for that purpose, we will pilot availability of children's menu items on train. Further, baby foods, hot milk and hot water would be made available on stations, and changing boards for babies will be provided in train toilets. With a view to enhancing passenger comfort, we are planning to reimagine the design and layout of our coaches to ensure higher carrying capacity, provision of new amenities including automatic doors, barcoded readers, bio-vacuum toilets, water level indicators, accessible dustbins, ergonomic seating, improved aesthetics, vending machines, entertainment screens, LED lit boards for the advertising, public announcement system and more. These new smart coaches would cater to emerging needs of our customers and to also ensure lower unit cost of operation due to higher carrying capacity. Presently, we have different digital solutions for ticketing, grievance redressal and other issues. We intend to integrate all such facilities into two mobile apps only, one dealing with ticketing issues and other on redressal and suggestion system.